Ministry of Finance has assured the Parliamentary Committee on Gender that the NSSF is ready to pay midterm access once the NSSF Amendment Bill 2021, which is before Parliament, is enacted into law. However, Finance wants its minister to be given powers to determine the percentage of midterm payouts every year, depending on the financial health of the fund. We have the details in the following report. The Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, today appeared before the Parliamentary Committee on Gender to justify the NSSF Amendment Bill 2021, especially the clause that places the Workers' Fund under supervision of the Ministry of Finance. Musasizi told the committee that NSSF is not only a workers' provident fund, but also a key source of financing to the national budget that has to be overseen by the line ministry.
NSSF's primary management function involves profitable investment of members' funds in a manner that maintains the value of the fund, gives a financial return to members, and a key source of financing for the national budget, as well as providing long-term capital for the economy.
Contrary to the earlier statements by the NSSF Managing Director Richard Biarugaba, the minister says the fund has the money to clear savers. NSSF needs 902 billion shillings to clear beneficiaries, but the minister says NSSF collects 3.2 trillion shillings per year from annual contributions and income on its investments, which puts it in a good position to pay up.
Allowing mid-term access will not lead to structural impairment of the fund, as reported in the newspapers. Mid-term access is affordable and should be enacted into law as agreed above. For those who have reached 45 years and above and have contributed for 10 years or more.
However, Finance wants the minister to be given powers to determine the percentage of midterm access to be paid out, ranging from 0 to 20%, depending on the financial health of the fund.
The minister will have powers to determine midterm access conditions and procedures for accessing midterm, including setting the percentage in a statutory instrument. The percentages may range from 0 to 20%, but the minister would not at any moment exceed the maximum cap of 20%, as provided in section 24A2.
But the committee members have disagreed with the Ministry of Finance on several issues, including the role of the minister to decide the percentage of midterm access, which is already provided for in the law at 20%.
This is workers. This is not money from taxation, I can assure you. This is workers' money in pain. That's why any single shilling lost through levy, the 700, the 7 billion, which you have just removed here, is cheating. It's cheating.
We see the president proposing that the Minister of Finance takes on the lead. And I want to ask you, Honorable Minister, according to the Finance Ministry, what has gone wrong with the Minister of Gender? Because for us, we report to the Minister of Gender. And we want to examine the gaps. What has happened that the president has gotten this interest that you take over NSSF?
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.